Collective. This one says, not all stars belong to the sky. Ooh, you might be becoming a star. Let's see. Or you could be an Aquarius. The star card in the tarot deck is the Aquarius. It does not have to be. You just could have that spark, boo-boo. Let's get into it. Magic prayer. Look at you manifesting. Asking spirit for what you want. You could be using this full moon to manifest. Tonight is the full moon, by the way. Full moon in Capricorn. Be sure to check that out. Take advantage of it for all your healthy in the light rituals. Field of dreams. Yes. I just heard, if you build it, they will come. Remember that movie? What was it called? Oh, it's fun. Field of Dreams, right? I think. Then it's called Field of Dreams. I'm thinking of that movie now. It could be relevant. It is baseball season. Baseball could be relevant. Some of you want to be a baseball player. I do see that coming in for you. Something at a baseball game, even. Baseball stadium. Oh my God, look at coming together. Some of you are trying to manifest love. The 8-8 portal next month, Lionsgate. 8-8, very significant for you for your manifestations. This full moon tonight, and then the 8-8 portal in August. Boom. Success will be yours, my friend. Especially for my athletes, I'm hearing. I don't know why. That's weird. I just saw Conor McGregor. Maybe some of you are MMA fighters. He is my favorite MMA fighter, by the way. Maybe that's why I saw them. Maybe you're perhaps going to meet a favorite baseball player or a favorite athlete. Some of you want to be scouted by an athlete. Or, like, get a scout to your games this year. I do see that being manifested. Use that 8-8 portal. School starts in September if it's for football. You got a really good chance of manifesting those scouts on that 8-8 portal. Coming to life and deep freeze. Ooh. Some of you, this is about love. Like you're trying to manifest, maybe not somebody specific, maybe you're just sick of being single, or you're sick of finding the same kind of men to date. You could be trying to manifest over this full moon a love that's true, like a twin flame or something, or a soulmate. You could have somebody in mind that you are trying to manifest here, but there's been some kind of stagnancy here. Maybe there was anger or distance, or you were just blocking yourself off from love. Oh my God, remember the 8-8 Lionsgate? They got the lion. Your spirit has been stuck. Like your energy, your life force, your drive for life, your happiness. There's like a little bit of depression, sadness here, pressure. I do see you coming out of that though. Protecting your treasure. Yeah, this is protecting your family, protecting the love that you want, protecting an investment, protecting those manifestations by keeping them on, like, don't allow people to know what you're doing. When people know what you're doing, they can do things against it magically. Spirit of place. Ooh. Oh. I kind of feel an energy vampire. But this protecting your treasure or like a place that's very, I'm getting this a lot today, demonic influences, not good ghosts. They've kind of been feeding on your emotions, feeding on your energy. Oh, I don't know why I'm being fooled, like... I meant to say pulled, but I said fooled. So somebody could be fooling you. Trying to get close to your treasure here. trying to break up a connection. Again, energy vampire. But I've been pulled to tell you that if you are on water, it's summer. Like, if you are sailing the seas, I wouldn't really worry too much about lakes unless, like, you grew up on a lake like mine. My camp, I just feel like it's relevant. Where I used to have a camp on Oneida Lake in New York, at least 2 people die there every summer, like drown or something happens in that water. That lake has taken a lot of lives. There's also another lake that's very famous right now that people want drained because anybody who goes in it dies. There's a lot of demonic things attached to water that are surfacing at this time. And if you are spending time on the ocean as a psychic medium, I cannot tell you how hard it is for me to be on sea compared to land. If you think a lot of people died on land, there is so many souls at unrest in the sea because, one, they've never been found. They were ate by sea life. You got the freaking Titanic, pirate ships. Wars used to be fought on water. People murder people and throw them overseas all the time, like just dumped in suitcases and whatever. Like, it is literally the biggest pit of unsolved murders and unrested souls. And I think a lot of the time that has been kind of contained with the amount of salt in the sea, but I don't think that matters anymore. There's some kind of shift here, like, and it's starting to happen in certain places. I don't know why I'm being pulled to tell you to protect your treasure. It's your literal gift. You're an empath, a psychic medium, or you're somebody who's sensitive to spirits. Particularly if you are a psychic medium on water, you could be being bothered by some nasty spirits. Especially if you're a strong person, if you're trying to manifest. They try to block the light as much as possible. This could be acting to block your success. Or this isn't an evil spirit. This is an evil person. Like a baby mama, baby daddy, a family member, a friend that is not wanting this to come together. Whatever is supposed to come together. Listening, yeah. Someone's listening. Peaks of joy. It's like eavesdrop energy. I don't know why I'm feeling this. Like, you got spies on you. Oh, man. Don't tell anybody your thoughts or feelings. 33 is relevant to. Like, notice those peaks of joy when you come away from certain people or when you come away from certain things. Oh, my God. I just went Irish for a second. That's crazy. Things. I don't know why that happens. That's in my lineage. I grew up in Ireland, though. That's funny. Maybe you're Irish. I did see Conor McGregor. He's from Ireland, too. Everything is a clue, my friends. Everything is a clue. But yeah, I think they're calling you to notice patterns with people if they're around and your energy like dips or you just start having negative thoughts. That's your secret hater. Don't tell them shit. Spirit's protecting you. You are their treasure. They are going to get you back up and out, but they can't do it alone. You got to work those positive affirmations. You got to call your energy back. You got to return to sender. You got to pray for protection. Something about music messages as well. Somebody could be listening to your phone calls, I heard. Jeez, what's going on? Wide open, yeah. You have everything available to you. You have all these gifts. I think you're just getting in your own way because you're being influenced by negative things and evilness. It's like you're forgetting your own strength. You're forgetting your own power. And when you call your power back to yourself and you remove yourself from these toxic situations, yeah, balancing act. Right now, you're in and out of good and bad energy. You need to ground yourself. Feel the ouch. Face the pain. Somebody hurt you. You got to come out of this. Open your heart up. Expand. And then good things come. Good contracts. Good friendships. Good relationships. But you definitely have someone out here trying to, like, keep you in this-ness. I don't like it. I don't like them. Get away from it. Yucky!